Hola, Shuggas. How y'all doing? How y'all doing? Yes. Okay. Welcome to my channel. It's your girl, Shana Danae. If you're new here, hey, Shuggas. If you are returning, hey, boos, what's good? What's goody? Okay, so listen. It is now 8:18 on a good Tuesday. What a day is. Tuesday. So, I'm actually going to do a foundation review on the new NARS Light Reflecting Foundation. I got it Friday. You know, I didn't have a no-buy, so I'm a little behind. But I'm still gonna give you a review and a full wear test today, which is why we're starting early. Okay, so I actually picked up two different shades. Don't worry if it doesn't work. I'm taking it back. So yeah. So, in all honesty, just a truthful moment. Now, I can't usually find a match in NARS. I think I only found one in the long-lasting radiant one, and that's the new Caledonia color. But in the soft matte one, I don't know. It just wasn't working for me. I never tried Sheer Glow. So this will be the third NARS foundation. And you know, she usually like $50. So if she don't work, we're taking her back. It's okay. So just to give you some info. So it's $49 at Sephora and Ulta. You can get it from either one, whichever is your preference. It has medium coverage, a natural finish. It is good for redness, dark spots, and dullness and uneven texture. So like I said earlier, I got two shades. I got one in the new Caledonia and another in Nambia. Just because of the undertone. So with new Caledonia, it's deep with warm undertones and an olive tone. And then the one they said that was close to me, they said Nambia, which is deep with warm undertones and a red tone. So I have, this is red, baby. So I have both, simply because I'm going off of what I know worked for me in the previous foundation that I actually liked. I like the shade New Caledonia on me. Of course, it has to do a little work, but I make it work for me. So that is new Nambia. Nambia. That's Nambia. And then, oh yeah, this is the packaging. I don't know if I said that. This is very impromptu. And this is what this is why this makes me so nervous. And this is what New Caledonia looks like in the thing. As you can see, they're two different. They're very different on the spectrum. I am gonna swatch them just to see which one may work on me. This sounds really liquidy. Real liquidy. I'm just gonna squirt some on my hand. This is. And that is New Caledonia. They're basically blended right in. Looks like Nambia probably got to go back. Unless she may be a summer shade. I don't know. Let's see. And then this is Nambia. Oh yeah, no. Oh yeah, she's way too dark. I don't even think she could be considered my summer shade at this point. And I usually don't use my fan, but for swatching purposes. Okay, so this is Nambia on this side, and then New Caledonia on this side. I legit think this may be my closer to my summer shade than right now, because it is February. It doesn't look bad at all, though. I mean, she's a little warm, but you know, but I think I'm gonna go with, for what my face is looking like, I think I'm gonna go with New Caledonia. I think Nambia will be too dark right now. But I think I'm gonna do another video solely using Nambia just to see. But yeah, okay. So we're gonna go with that one and go for broke. Okay. And then we could do a wear test. I'm not gonna hold you. Nambia surprised me because I really thought she was gonna be entirely too dark, but she's not. I don't know. We're gonna have to try her another day. But for this, we're gonna do New Caledonia because I kind of like her. I am going to go ahead and prep my face. With the e.l.f. Power Grip. This is definitely dupe vibes for Milk Hydro Grip, and it's $10. You can get it at any drugstore, Target, Ulta. You know the vibes. Whew. This has become probably one of my favorites of my new purchases. I bought this before my Nova started. Baby, when I tell you, she holds on to the makeup, baby. She holds on to the makeup. And my eyebrows are, I use the Juvia's in dark brown. Patrick Stars one size concealer to clean them up, and Mocha Mommy bronzer as my eyeshadow. Lily Lashes are NYC, and the liner is Maybelline. Okay, now that that's on, we're gonna go ahead. Oops, excuse me, that was rude. Shake her up some more just for, you know, kicks and giggles. And I'm just gonna apply her directly to the brush. 1, 2. She's very liquidy. Like I said, it's medium coverage. I didn't see where it said it was buildable though. But I mean, you know, we can see. We can definitely see how this goes. I think Nambia matches the outside of my face probably better than New Caledonia, but by the time I do everything, I think New Caledonia is the better match. Y'all tell me what y'all think. I could be wrong, you know, but what I'm seeing is that this is definitely better than, you know, they're not. But now that I think about it, I now think I'm gonna keep Nambia. Just off the strength that I think it's gonna work for me during the summertime, and it's lightweight. We're just giving skin right now, and I'm kind of liking it. Now I will say I am a full coverage girl. I'm not gonna pretend like I'm not. I don't really have necessarily hyperpigmentation. I do have this scar right here. I was definitely a tomboy, of course, around my mouth. I don't color correct. I probably should, but I just don't. And I have moles. That's about it. some raised moles, but other than that, I don't really have hyperpigmentation or anything like that. Now, I am combo oily, so I normally go for very much mattifying products, but I will try any foundation finish and make it work for my skin. I think that's one thing a lot of people don't really, you know, they feel like they're stuck in this one category. Oh, if it's not this, I can't. Because truthfully, I like, for example, I like some of my radiant foundations better than some of my mattes. It just depends on the mood, you know? But, okay. So, that is the foundation blended. As you can see, I'm giving very much, you know, skin. It looked like a good match to y'all. Of course, we're going to do everything else, but... So, I'm going to finish the rest of my face. I'm really not mad at this, though. But anyways, we'll get to that. So, I'm going to finish the rest of my face and show y'all the finished look. I do not have a NARS concealer anymore. I actually got rid of it in a declutter because I didn't use it. It wasn't being used, and at some point I was just like, okay, this has to give. So yeah, I'm gonna finish the rest of my face and I'll be back. We're gonna just play some music and speed through this part.
You are listening to an official remix of Music with Effects.
You had me at hello. Could never make you happy, girl. It must be the devil. Beautiful lies. Don't break my heart. Tell me beautiful lies. She's an emotional wreck right now. She got some things on her chest right now. I bet she's looking at my text right now. Don't do me bad like that. Can't take you back if you in the past like that. All the reason why you been in your bed like that. Don't get this shit confused. You lied to me, I won't believe you again. But fuck that shit, you'll never see me again. Came in my life and now you leaving again. You telling me beautiful lies. Don't break my heart. Tell me beautiful lies. I want to believe you when you say that you always love. Tell me beautiful lies. Beautiful lies.
What can I say to you? Really nothing I can take back. Getting farther from the right track. And I'm in this place with you. Every day is like you're on attack. And we can't keep getting down like that. Cause we be falling out. You keep fucking up. You apologize and I suck it up. Try to
tough enough,
is another love. You're telling me
beautiful lies. Don't you break my heart. Tell me beautiful lies.
I want to believe you when you say that you'll always love me that way. Beautiful lies.
Don't wanna see you, but I need your love. Head eyes shoot like cause they be sleep on us. Licking on it and you feel deep in love. Baby, come and tell me what you need from love. Let me hear.
Okay, so boom. This is the final look. I will say first impressions, I ain't mad at it. I mean, my face looks impeccable. Like, look, do you see? Okay, so I am officially done at 8:51 and I will check back in around lunchtime. And yeah, we're going to see how this holds up. I have to work all day and yeah. So this is the final look. We'll be back with a check-in and some pictures and all that jazz so you can know. Should you get it? Is it worth the hype? are the girls telling the truth or nah? Okay, so I'll be back. Gotta go do some work. Bye, Shuggas. See you in the mini. Good evening, and my battery's about to die, so this has to be quick. So the time is now 3:02. We finished my makeup at 9 o'clock. So it's been about 6 hours of wear time. Yes, I've had my glasses on the whole time because I'm at work and I cannot see. Yes, so this is it. I'm gonna take my glasses off, show you my face. I'm not gonna touch up, just show you my face. Again, I'm combo oily. And of course I'm glistening a little bit, but you know, we like some natural dew glow, whatever. I don't look disgusting. So it's 3 o'clock. I get off in like maybe an hour, hour and a half. Then, yeah, I'm gonna go run some errands and come back, and then we're gonna do a full review. But again, my check-in is at 3. It was supposed to be at 12, but life happens, and here we are. So, yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. What y'all think so far? What we doing? How we doing? How we living? How we looking? And I've had my glasses on all day. And yes, I need them. Hey, Shuggas. Okay. So, we are at our final check-in and the end of the day. It is now 6:18. I finished my face at 9 o'clock. So, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 9 hours of wear of the new NARS, what is it called? Light Reflecting Foundation. Okay. So, off the rip, I like how it just off the rip. Let's see. Let me remind y'all what it says. It do. What's the... Okay. See your skin in its best light. Light Reflecting Foundation instantly diffuses light to blur imperfections and smooth the look of skin. Powered by skincare ingredients, this product strengthens skin's barrier to maintain moisture day by day. This formula visibly improves skin clarity even after makeup is removed. It's medium buildable coverage, natural finish, and breathable all day wear. So, as I stated, I've had this on for 9 hours. For the record, I usually do not wear makeup all day. It's legit for whatever the assignment is, and I go wash my face. And that's just because I don't be doing nothing. I don't go anywhere. So, with that being said, this is a full... Sorry, Coco is... You good? Okay. So, as I was saying, this is the longest I've worn a foundation in a while. I will say it's definitely light on, like, I don't feel it on my face, if that makes sense. You know how some foundations you feel heavy? Definitely don't. I do not mind the natural finish whatsoever. It's really, really good. Like I said, I'm oily to combo, so this is expected. But it still does not look disgusting. Like, I'm still cute. Like, I'm still cute. No edges down or nothing. So, I'm pretty sure if I just... I don't own blotting paper, by the way. I just never got any. So, if I just take a napkin and just press it where the oil came through. You know, lightly tap, tap, tap. Then, I'm back to business. Like... Period. As you can see, now I'm not as shiny. Just picking up that excess oil. And then, of course, if I wanted to blot anywhere else, I could. I did have to go to the store. I did have to go to Target and a couple other places, so I did have to wear a mask. But legit, it wasn't an extended time. I work from home, so yeah. But this is like after a full day's wear, running errands and things of that nature. And I can't lie, I like it. Like, I think everybody else was making soft matte. That girl, I mean, she was alright, but I think the color just kind of made me be like, I don't like it. I would definitely recommend this to my friends, especially the girls who don't like a full coverage foundation, but like, and then you like that, like, what is it called? That medium build. This is it. Would highly recommend. My lash is trying to leave me though. I would definitely wear this all day, every day. Like, grab this. Oh, you want to go? Cool. This is it. The color Nambia that I swatched on this side earlier, I think that's probably more my summertime shade when we outside. But I think New Caledonia, and I hope I'm saying that right, is the best shade for me. I'm gonna swatch them side by side because I realized I didn't do that. I mean, I swatched them on my face, but you know, just so you can get a better idea, because I think that I'm a visual person, so I get it. Like, so let's go ahead and squirt Nambia because that's the darkest one, and it's very liquidy and runny, but the coverage alone is just like so pretty. So boom, that's Nambia on my hand now, and then I'm going to swatch New Caledonia, and it definitely says shake beforehand, so shake well. Like I said, it's very liquidy, so yeah, as you can hear it, you probably can't hear it, but you can hear the liquid moving. And then I'm just gonna squirt one pump and then take that. So that's both of them on my hand. This is definitely warmer and redder, but during the summertime, I get redder. So that would be it, and this is more. And I wonder what they look like if you mix them together. Probably hella orange, but then again. And that's them mixed together, if you can see. So, yeah, I definitely. Ooh, I definitely could mix them together. Sorry, squirrel. So yeah, I genuinely like this foundation. Like I said, I don't be sold on NARS like that, but this is probably the first one outside of the, what is it called? The long lasting one. I'll have it somewhere up here or the name pop up because I can't remember what it's called. I definitely like that one out of all the ones she's had. Like I said, I have soft matte. I think because the colors didn't really transfer all that great, it just wasn't for me. I didn't like it. I can find something else soft matte that'll do its justice for half the price, a little cheaper than $50. But the rundown of the products, it is $49. You can get it at Ulta and Sephora, and of course NARS website. Is it 1 fluid ounce? I think it is. Yep, 1 fluid ounce. Don't remember how many shades it comes in, but I feel like they did extend it. I do know they did extend it, so it's a good shade range. And yeah, I mean, I like it. My lash is trying to embarrass me, but whatever, we got the show must go on. So yeah, that is the end of this video. Thank y'all for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Let me know if y'all bought it down below, if you're thinking about getting it. I think you can definitely get samples from both Ulta and Sephora if you just want to try it. I say try it. I think this will definitely be nice for the spring, summertime, summer, spring. And I think it is, with the right prep, us oily girls can make it work. A little dab dab here, a little doop doop there, you should be fine. And it's not heavy. I don't think my face would melt away for somebody who doesn't care to wear makeup during the summertime, because I sweat in my face. But would definitely recommend. So yeah, thank y'all for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and see y'all next time. Bye.